Everybody, this is Bronco Juggalo, and it's time for another 12 Days of Christmas Horror. Hey, I am doing the 2018 Shudder exclusive Christmas presents. Not presents like gifts, but presents as in like there's a ghostly presence, that kind of presence. Directed by James Edward Cook, and starring Charlotte Atkins as Mackenzie and Lorna Brown as Anita. A diverse group of friends gather on a rural lodge in rural England for a Christmas holiday weekend, and the Christmas holiday weekend turns into haunted terror. This movie is also known as Why Hide, and honestly, it wasn't bad. I did enjoy this movie, you know, for the most part. It does have its cons. I'm going to give it those first. The first con is that it's really slow at the beginning. It takes about 45 to 46 minutes for anything to happen in this movie. And that usually would be a really bad thing on the most part. And for a little bit, I was kind of like, eh, how much longer is this? But what happens with the characters and the characters themselves are enough to keep my attention and keep me interested in the film. Some of the pros for it is that it looks great. It is beautifully shot. There's some big scenic scenes, some big sweeping scenes, a lot of nice overhead shots when they're outside. The inside shots are tight and they're well done, and I really did enjoy the way this film looked. Another thing I really enjoyed is I thought the acting was pretty good. I think all the actors did a decent job, and they really brought out their characters, and I really enjoyed that. There is some good character development in this movie, and that's something else I enjoyed. All the diverse characters, this movie shows the way, in my opinion, the way society should be as far as these friends went. I also love that there is almost like an anti-agenda in this movie, which I absolutely loved. And it speaks to all these agendas that are being pushed now and kind of shows the fallacies in them. And I did enjoy that as well. And the fact that it's done by people that are part of those agendas is really cool. I thought that the humor was really good and on point. I read some other reviews where people didn't like the humor. The humor is British humor, but it's not only British humor, it's New Age British humor. If you don't know much about that, you're probably not going to get it. I did enjoy it, though. I thought it was funny. I liked it. The movie itself is pretty good. There's not a lot of blood and gore. There is not a lot of... It's really not that scary, either. It's very much a haunted movie where some things do happen. There is some, like, stabbings and things like that because people get possessed or they think that they're seeing things or whatever, and they're being manipulated by the spirit. And the end has kind of not really a twist, but something interesting happens at the end. And I enjoyed the film throughout, honestly. Like I said, it is a bit slow. The first 45 minutes, first half of the movie could have been maybe cut down a little bit, but then we would have lost a lot of the good character development, and that part I did enjoy. Guys, before we sign out, I want to thank my buddy Horrific Nightmares JM, my Super Slash brother, for coming up with the 12 Days of Christmas. We've done this now for 3 years running, and it's been a blast every time. Can't wait to see you guys tomorrow with another review. This is Bronco Juggalo saying Merry fucking Christmas, everybody.
Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. A Murder City Christmas.
West side, east side.
On the east side where we ride or die. Blowing green trees underneath Christmas lights. Got the sweet leaf passing when the time is right. I'm a killer motherfucker tonight.
Sounds tight.
On the west side, Santa smokes PCP.
wrecked this slang, got stuck in a tree.